today's agenda is we will be covering the transaction account rules. How do we configure the transaction account rules? And how does the approvals work? Okay, so these two boxes we will be covering today. What are transaction account rules? What are the accounting behind the scenes? How does those accounts get defaulted into your purchase orders or in your acquisitions, in your receipt? Okay, so now what is TAB? Okay, so what is transaction account builder? Transaction account builder is used to derive the default account code combinations for Oracle Fusion purchasing transactions. So this is transaction account builder is specifically for your Oracle purchasing transactions, and we use this transaction accounting builder to derive the default combination. So whenever we are entering a requisition, we enter a purchase order, there are certain accounts that are there in the distributions. How those accounts and combinations get defaulted is on basis of TAB. So we define certain configuration, and these accounts are charge account, accrual account, and variance account. So you define all the configuration in the transaction accounting builder. What is this charge account? Charge account is nothing, is just to which particular account, whenever you are purchasing, it will be, the expense would be charged. Whether if it is an item, it is an inventory item, it would be a current asset account. If it is an expense item, it would be an expense account. Or if it is an asset item, it would be an asset account. Can you tell me what is an inventory item? How do you place it in your balance sheet? Is it an asset? Is it an expense? What is an inventory item?
An asset.
Right. But what asset? Current asset or a fixed asset?
Current assets.
Right. Exactly. Do you, everyone understands the difference between a current asset, inventory item, and a fixed assets, right? Okay. I'll quickly explain that in one line. So, the difference between a current asset and a fixed asset is, let's say if we talk about Lenovo manufactures laptops and they sell laptop. So for them, that laptop is not a fixed asset. That will be a current asset because they are selling that, right? Anything that they are using in their organization, like if they have plant and machinery and buildings, all those would be their fixed assets. But for other organizations, like for any consulting firms, they are buying laptops for their employees. For them, those laptops will not be current assets because they haven't bought those assets for the intention of reselling it. So that is not their inventory item or current assets. Inventory items are all treated as current assets, which we intend to buy and resell, or we use for manufacturing. So those are all our current assets. And fixed assets are long term that we use in our business processes. So that is the difference. So depending upon the type of item we are purchasing, whether it is an inventory item and an expense item, or it is an asset item, we will be using the charge account for it. Okay. So then transaction account types, like allow your subledger application to categorize different accounts that are generated for your transaction. So we can derive these accounting combinations, and we can like automatically all these accounts can be defaulted in your transactions. And what is a accrual account? Does anyone understand what is an accrual account? Okay, so whenever we create a purchase order and whenever we receive the items, whether whatever type of item it is, it doesn't matter. So you receive your items, and if you do not invoice that items in that period when you have received it, let's say you have ordered in the month of January, you receive those items in January, but for some reason the supplier did not send you the invoice in the month of January. They send it in the month of February. So there is an accounting principle which says whenever you have expense, because you have already expensed that particular item and you have received that item and you start using it or you have placed it in your inventory, whatever, you have to create the invoice in that period itself. Okay. So now in this case, what we do is we create some accrual entries and we instead of an expense account, we use the accrual account and we expense that item in that particular month only. Okay? And in the next period, in February, we reverse this accounting entry. So the accounting actual at the end of the year, if we see, there is no impact on the accrual entry. But for the month of January, if we run the reports, we will find that we have already expensed this particular item or whatever, if it is inventory item or something, we have done the inventory valuation. And when we receive the actual invoice, then the final entries are passed in February.
No, but what is that? Why do we do it?
That's what I said, that it is an accounting principle which states that in whichever period you are expensing, in that period itself you should account it. But if you haven't received the invoices, system does not generate the accounting entry in that case. So that is the reason we generate the accrual entries,
Simple
so
like
that we
that.
can ex simple it so that we can expense it in that particular period itself, and we reverse this entry in the next period, so that when the actual invoice comes, there will be an actual accounting entry in the month of February. We have to define these transaction accounting builder setups in this particular. These are the setups and these are the setup flows that you have. So first you have are the sources, that is the mapping sets. So you can define the mapping sets, then you define the account rules, then you define the transaction accounting definition, and then you define the subledger application setup. For our understanding purpose, we will go in a reverse manner so that you understand how things work. So we will see this subledger application setup first, then we will see the transaction account definition, then we will see the account rules, and then the mapping sets. I'll discuss this account rule and what is all the sources and all. So basically, it is the main thing here is the account rule. Account rule is something where we specify how the account is going to get defaulted, and then we have a general definition, transaction account definition, where we have all the accounts. We have accrual account and variance account. We have PO charge account. So we give each account rule to each of these accounts based on this definition that we have defined in the account rules. Automatically, this transaction account definition will behave, and then you will attach it to the subledger application setup. That is your purchasing area, which particular definition you want to use. So for each individual account, you will define these account rules, and those account rules can have different sources. That account rule can get the definition from another account rule. So you can define one account rule and then the second account rule, and the source can be another account rule, or you can specify a constant value, or you can specify something called as mapping sets. We will discuss what is mapping sets. So account rule you can define, and you can define various conditions as well. If this condition is satisfied, then this combination should be picked up from the account rule and assigned to the PO charge account or like that. So for our definition, we'll first understand the each of these components, and then we will go to the application and see this in a reverse manner. We have this transaction account definition. In this transaction account definition, so we have all the accounts, transaction account times that are listed here. Let me open this in the system. I will open this transaction account definition first, and I will open the purchasing tab default accounting here.
This is something which is a feed data, or is this something somebody created?
Yeah, I'm explaining that once again. So by default, one transaction account definition is already there in the system. Okay, purchasing tab default accounting created by application, right? So you have all these accounts, accrual account, charge account, variance account, destination charge account and destination variance account. So now here you will be having all your segments on the right hand side to whatever chart of accounts you will be attaching to it. So whatever chart of accounts that you attach to this particular definition, those segments, those chart of account segments appear here. So we have how many segments in our chart of account that we are using for Marsh company, right? So what we have to do is, first time when you define this definition, you don't have to start creating it from scratch. We don't create it from scratch. We just duplicate this. Okay, you just give a name to it. And then you select the chart of accounts here. We used Apps Diffusion chart of accounts, right? So what you will do is, you will come to this purchasing tab default accounting, you will just copy it, and this is how you will create this particular definition. Now, so you specify this combination rule. Account rules can be of two type. You can derive the complete combination, or you can just derive the segment. Now you understand what is a combination and what is a segment value, right?
Yes, combination is all three of them together on each one of them.
Correct. Let me open the WordPad. So we can derive these combination rules or the segment rules. So you can derive the whole combination. Let's say you write a rule and you say, I want to derive the complete combination. Let's say 01000 or something. This is your account combination, right? Or you can derive only a particular segment value. You write this rule for a segment value for account, let's say. Okay. Now you want to derive only this particular account. So you can derive only a particular account or a combination. Now you can attach the combination rule here, or you can define three segment rules. You want to use three different rules to derive the segments. So that also you can do here. Right. One more thing, you can define a default combination rule, and let's say for every thing you want to derive the account separately. So the account segment value should be defined separately. Though you have defined the combination rule, you can also give account rules here. So account rule will take precedence over the combination rule. Let's say, for example, the combination rules gives us this value. But in the account rule, we have specified, no, the value should be some 30. So system will first derive this particular combination, and then it will go, it will check the combination rule and it will derive the combination. Then it will go to the segment rules and check whether there are any rules for each individual segments. If they find a rule here, let's say for account rule, they find a particular segment rule, and that segment rule says the account should be 111130. So it will override this value and bring up 111130 here. So this is how the combination rule and the segment rule works. We will define both combination rule. We'll take an example and define both combination rule and account rule, and we'll see that in the system.
On the screen, I can see the segment rules like company, department, and account, but I don't see the combination you showed me.
This is the combination rule, account combination rule. So these are all the combination rules.
When you say purchasing account, purchasing accrual account rule, it's a combination of some three numbers behind the scene.
Okay, so these rules, we will change these rules. These rules are coming. You remember we have copied this definition.
Yes.
So these rules are coming from there. These are the default rules that Oracle provides. If you want, you can go and edit these rules. But we will create these rules, like these rules, from scratch. We don't create definition from scratch, but these are the copied rules. I'll open and show you them. that's why they are already coming here.
Okay, so behind the scene, this description is mapped to a combination which you just showed us on the an example.
Correct. Oh, I did not save it. Because like you will be having different account values for different categories. If you have different regions, you might want to use different departments, different locations. So that is very much required. That you do not do here in the drop down, that you do in the rules.
Okay. Is this something done by like the finance guys or the P2P?
No, this is done by the procurement consultants.
Okay.
You have a discussion with the finance people and you ask for the account values, like which account will be used, like this, if this account is to be used, whether it is an expense account, inventory account, those account is given by the finance people, but the this setups and definition is done by the procurement consultants only.
But we still need to know which all accounts to ask them for.
Yes.
Okay.
It is the business finance team or business procurement team, like they can give you those accounts. Then you have these transaction account types that are provided here. So these you don't have to do anything. You see these are created by default for purchasing, accrual account, charge account and variance accounts. So you do not have to do anything for this. You don't create duplicate or anything. This is just for your reference purpose so that you can come and view it. This is given by Oracle. So you don't have to do anything for the account types, the type of accounts, because these are the only accounts that are behind the scenes, behind purchase orders and receipts. Then you have the account rules. These are my account rules. So what are account rules? Account rules are used to determine the accounts for your subledger journal entries. So each transaction that we enter in the system, whether it is your purchase order, whether it is your like requisitions, receipts, everything will have a account code, but not necessarily that will result into a journal entry. Though the requisition and purchase orders has certain PO charge account, variance accounts and accrual accounts, but the accounting entry only gets generated at the time when we do the receiving. There is no accounting entry for requisition. There is no accounting entry for a purchase order. But those account codes still will be there. That is like a separate discussion. We'll discuss the accounting entry separately, but we are discussing this defaulting of the combinations first. So accounting rules by combination, account rule by segment, right? So now you understand what is a combination rule and what is a segment rule. I've given an example, like you want to derive the complete account combination from this rule, or you want to derive the only the account, use the account rule by segment and derive only one particular segment. So like this you can define.
Ashish, can you go to the previous screen 1 second?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So in this account rule by combination, where you give the example is 101.100.1001, the next one is account rule by segment. In this, say that if I am deriving just the first segment, 01 is the example you are given. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
The understanding is correct, right?
Yeah.
When you're deriving it, you are just deriving one section for it, or do you always use the entire combination and you're replacing one segment inside it?
Okay, so we have to by default define all the combination rules. Okay, but if you want, you can, if your needs are fulfilled by the combination rule itself, and like there can be thousands of combinations, you cannot define all the thousands of combinations in the rules. Like for example, based on the categories, like you have different categories, for each category there is a separate account. But what you can do is, in that case, you can attach a default combination rule, but just for the account segment, you can say if category is X, the account is 1001. If category is Y, then account is 1002. If it is Z, it is 1003. So you will define a default combination rule and you will attach it to the charge account. And you will also create one segment rule based on the category, and you will attach it to the segment rule. So combination will just give a default combination. This will be the combination defaulted. And depending upon the category that you select in your purchase order, automatically this account is going to be changed.